911, what is your emergency?
Okay, we have somebody I believe is having a seizure. He's never had one before that I know of.
Okay, where at?
Oh, he might be choking. We are at Millwood, 30311, Emerald Valley Parkway.
Okay, and how old is this person?
Probably 35.
And what is going on with him?
Okay, it looked as if he had a seizure and then choked.
Okay, was he awake and breathing?
No, leave him upright.
Was he able to get it up?
No, he is not breathing.
We had our safety lunch was going on. Most of the crew was in the lunchroom eating their lunch. Hannah and I were sitting in here eating our lunch. We heard Cobb yelling. He was yelling a name. The sounds, the chairs scooting and people moving and yelling, it almost sounded like there was a fight. So both of us jumped up and ran out there and saw that Deloren was on the floor. Ernesto was trying to pick him up. Daniel was trying to help with that. Cobb was trying to help with that. I came back in here to get my phone and call 911. Hannah stood out there and gave directions. Do the Heimlich thrusts, get him up, try the thrusts, until each one was followed. And then as those either didn't work or seemed to work, she would move on to the next direction until that one was followed.
At first, I wasn't as severe or didn't get as severe. He was still like coherent. His eyes were still in the front of his head. He still had color. But then after Cobb had done a few attempts at the Heimlich and he had just like slumped, dead weight, gone. And I had opened his eyes and his eyes were rolled and he was not making any sound.
Eventually, he was on the ground and 911 was saying to do CPR. Hannah got in and started doing chest compressions.
My initial thought was, I have to help this man. He has children at home, and I would want to know that my dad didn't come home. The only thing going through my head was, you have to try and do everything you can to help him. It was like just a realization that I had his whole life in my hands at one point, that my hands pushing on him was keeping him alive.
Finally, I got around behind him to get his head up, to tilt his head back. And then he had started to gasp. Some breathing was happening at that point. He hadn't been breathing for quite a while.
Our supervisor, Cobb, said something, and I just remember laughing. And then from the point me laughing, like I don't even remember even getting up from my seat. Just next thing you know, I remember waking up in the hospital. Honestly, I couldn't believe it happened so fast. I was going outside thinking maybe I need to get some air in to try to spit it out. But honestly, like talking to them, I'm glad I didn't make it outside because like we say, I get outside, ain't nobody out there, nobody know I would've failed. Jumping into action quick as they did is, would save my life, honestly.
Those first years of me coming to Glenwillow, it was a tension. There was a tension between Latinos and African Americans. They would eat in a separate, corners, maybe outside. One of the Latinos, Francisco, he was outside driving, and when he heard that somebody had passed, he heard that somebody had died in the break room. So when he learned that was Deloren, he ran right away. He said, no, he's my buddy, he's my friend, he cannot die. 2 days before that incident, Francisco had shared his lunch with Jordan, because Jordan forgot his lunch, and Francisco was sharing his lunch with his African-American brother. This incident, it really gave me a complete, and it gave the whole team, the whole plant, a new story to write about. They became one. Let me tell you, I got some tears out of that.
He was, I guess, taken to ICU and then released that very next day. Everybody was so relieved. He walked in Monday and I think half the crew hugged him. Everybody, family. I mean, I could hear the people who weren't right there, I could hear praying. Ernesto was helping those who couldn't understand the English or what was happening, helping them to understand.
When I had heard that he was up, moving, walking, talking good, I was so elated. Oh my gosh. If anybody had anything wrong or anything happened, that all of these people here are here to try and do what they can to help you.
I got a place in my heart for everybody here, because we all get along with each other, you know what I'm saying? We a big family here. We love each other. We all laugh. We all find some type of way to crack a joke on each other, you know what I'm saying? We cool. I love it. Like, it can't get no better, man.
You can't even imagine how much love and concern was in that room at that time. You just can't even picture it. You can't imagine it.